वेलकम स्टूडेंट, लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद दिस लेसन। लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद दिस लेसन दैट इज रिलीजियस ट्रेंड्स इन एंशंट इंडिया। रिलीजियस ट्रेंड्स in ancient India, towards the end of the Vedic period, the minute details of the yajna rites acquired undue importance. Only the priestly class had a knowledge of those details. Others no longer had the freedom to gain that knowledge. The Varna system restrictions become very hard in the course of time. A person's social position was decided by the Varna into which he was born rather than by his achievements. That is why more from the Upanishad period, more than That is why from the Upanishad period we see that attempts were made to give a wider scope to religious thoughts and not restrict it only to yajna rites. However, the thoughts in Upanishads focused on the existence and the nature of soul. It was difficult for ordinary people to understand it. So at the time, at the period of the Upanishad, it is the literature totally focus on the existence and nature of the soul, and it is very hard to understand about the soul. The soul philosophy is composed by the Brahmins, so it is very hard. They did not give their knowledge to the other business people. So the whole knowledge of Upanishad, Aranyaka, and Vedas restricted up to the priestly class. After that, when this priestly class get importance through the yajnas, the meaning or we can say the scientific method of the yajnas were disappear, and for many other purpose these yajnas were performed for just their gaining importance in the society. So real yajnas were very rare in the Upanishad period. Okay, these priestly class like Brahmins at that time these Brahmins were restrict knowledge. So the whole other society feeling that there is unjust with them, and the no God is connected directly with the other varna people, so they are generate an unrest in the mindset. So they find the another path. The peoples who get birth in the other caste, some are started the new religions such as Gautam Buddha, Bhagwan Mahavir, and the new thoughts. They introduce new thoughts in the society. So these thoughts were attracted by the common people. Okay. Let us continue with the explanations and reading both. Okay. Certain trends around the 16th BCE made attempts to express religious thoughts in such a way that the common man could understand it easily. Many people realize that every person is free to find the way of his own upliftment. This leads to the establishment of a new religion. These religious emphatically stated that the discriminations on the basis of caste has no place in an individual's upliftment. The work of Vardhaman Mahavir and Gautam Buddha is of a special importance among the proponents of a new thoughts. Jainism, Bhagwan Mahavir, Jainism. Jainism is one of the ancient religion in India. The religion gives importance to the principles of non-violence. According to the Jain traditions, a person who reveals religious knowledge is known as the Tirthankar. There have been 24 Tirthankars in all. Vardhaman Mahavir is the 24th Tirthankar in Jain religious tradition. So here the Jain religions was come into existence on the principles of Ahimsa. The peoples belongs to the Jain religions are very, very cautious, calm, and they perform so much dan activity, which has importance in our society. So the major dans of economically and materials were made by these persons belongs to the Jain community. This community is considered to be the rich because of their honesty, hard working, and majorly their belief in the Jain principle. They are very strict to give respect to their gurus. Who devote their life for the upliftment of the Jain community. So these gurus, the Tirthankar, there are 24 Tirthankars in this religions. So there are many disciples who sacrifice their life for the development of the Jainism. Vardhaman Mahavir from 599 BCE to 527 BCE, so it is before Christ, before Islam and before Christianity. Jain religions were started. There was a Mahajanapadas known as a Braj. It is in the state of Bihar. Its capital was Vaishali. Vardhaman Mahavir was born in a Kundagram, a part of Vaishali. His father's name was Siddharth and mother's Trishala. Vardhaman Mahavir left his home and all comforts for the attainment of the knowledge. He attained the enlightenment after the 12.5 years of rigorous tapa. This knowledge was pure or keval. Therefore, he is also known as a kevali. He was called Jina or conqueror because the joy derived from the physical comfort and the discomfort felt due to undesired things had no impact whatsoever on him. The terms Jain derived from the word Jina. Vardhaman is said that the Mahavir, because he has a resilience, the courage to conquer all the passions, after the attainment of the knowledge, he preached for the 30 years to explain the essence of religion to people. To make it easy for people to understand it, he spoke to them in Ardhamagadhi, a people's language. The religions that is expounded laid stress on the good conduct, the essence of his teaching for good conduct is contained in the 5 great vows, Pancha Mahavataras, and the 3 jewels, that is 3 ratna. The assembly held by the Tirthankar to preach the people was known as Samvasaram. In Ardhamagadhi, Samvasaram was based on equality. The people of all Varnas had entry to it. So here, these Pancha Mahavataras, 5 great oaths, that is Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya, Aparigraha, Brahmacharya, and 3 ratnas. 3 ratnas were Samyak Darshan, Samyak Gyan, and Samyak Charitram. That is right faith, right knowledge, and right conduct. Samyak means balanced. So these are the values of Jainism, which the peoples belongs to the Jain followed in their life. These principles have main importance in their life. Samyak Darshan, the meaning of Samyak Darshan is to understand the truth in the preaching of the Tirthankar and to have a faith in it. Samyak Gyan, studying the preaching and philosophy, Tirthankars regularly learning its deep meaning. Samyak Charitra, strictly follow the 5 great vows. So students, we will continue with these lessons into the next lecture. Okay.